In this video, you'll see how to run queries across Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus Workspaces. With this solution, you can deploy Promsky, an open-source Prometheus proxy, in your container cluster to enable a single Grafana data source for querying multiple Prometheus Workspaces. Let's quickly review the solution architecture. We have three Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus Workspaces receiving metrics from multiple Amazon Elastic Kubernetes Service, or Amazon EKS, clusters. Promsky is deployed between Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus and Amazon Managed Grafana. Two ingress resources provide basic authentication and application load balancing. Note that we're using Amazon EKS, but other platforms can be used. To get started, let's go to Cloud9 to prepare our Amazon EKS cluster. First, we'll associate an AWS Identity and Access Management, or IAM, role with our service account. To do this, we need an IAM OpenID Connect, or OIDC, identity provider for our cluster. Let's run a command to determine whether we have one configured. Our cluster does have an IAM OIDC identity provider. If we didn't have an IAM OIDC identity provider, we could create one by following these instructions in the AWS documentation. The first step in our deployment is installing the Application Load Balancer controller, which automatically provisions an application load balancer when a Kubernetes ingress resource is created. This website provides instructions for creating the necessary IAM policy, role, and Kubernetes service account. For the purposes of this example, we've already gone through this process, so we're ready to deploy the application load balancer Helm chart. Let's return to Cloud9 and do so. Now that the controller is deployed, let's verify the resources. Promsky doesn't provide an authentication mechanism, so we'll use the Ingress Engine X controller for authentication. Let's deploy the Ingress Engine X Helm chart. Notice that we're setting the service type to Node port. This is to prevent the Engine X controller from automatically creating the classic load balancer for ingress resources. Instead, we'll be using the AWS Load Balancer controller to create an application load balancer. Next, let's verify the resources. To complete the authentication setup, we'll create a username and password, then convert them into a Kubernetes secret. Let's examine the secret to confirm that it was properly created. Let's go to the AWS Management Console. To prepare for Promsky deployment, we need to create an IAM role to give Promsky permissions to query metrics from Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus Workspaces. We'll create a custom trust policy. The trust policy will specify the account ID, region, and OIDC identity provider information. Next, we'll add the AWS managed policy that provides query access to Prometheus. Let's enter a name for the role and create it. Before we deploy Promsky, we need to make some changes and additions to the files. Let's clone the Promsky GitHub repository to our local file system. Next, we'll create some supplementary files to modify the default Promsky deployment and create additional files for the application load balancer and Ingress Engine X resources. The first file we'll create will provide values to overwrite the default Promsky configuration and define additional values that we're adding to the Promsky deployment. First, we define the service account to be used. We then disable the default ingress resource provided by Promsky. Next, we create two new ingress resources, one for the application load balancer and one for Nginx. Next, we define a sidecar container that utilizes AWS Signature version 4 to add authentication information to calls that Promsky makes to Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus. Finally, we define the Prometheus workspace connection details. Note that the entire static configs section is duplicated, and each contains a separate workspace ID. This section should be replicated for every Amazon Managed Service for Prometheus workspace to which Promsky will proxy requests. Next, we need to create the files that define our ingress resources. Let's go to the templates directory. Here we'll create two files. The first one is for the application load balancer ingress resource. Second, we'll create the file that defines the Nginx ingress resource. Next, in addition to adding the AWS Signature version 4 sidecar container to our override file, we need to ensure that it gets added to the default deployment.yaml file so that the container gets deployed. Near the end of this file, we can see that the sidecar container has been defined. We are now ready to deploy the Promsky Helm chart. Let's go to the base directory where the Promsky GitHub repository was cloned and initiate the deployment. Let's verify the resources. Once the deployment is complete, the application load balancer will be automatically deployed. Let's obtain the application load balancer URL. We'll use this URL when we define the data source in Grafana. Now we're ready to define our Grafana data source and create visualizations. Let's create a new Prometheus data source within our Amazon-managed Grafana workspace. We'll name our data source Promsky. Let's paste in the application load balancer URL we obtained. We'll enable basic authentication and specify the username and password we defined earlier. Let's save and test the data source. Notice that it says the data source is working. Let's explore the data source. As you can see, we have multiple EKS clusters, each writing to a separate Amazon-managed service for Prometheus workspace. Let's open a dashboard that displays the Prometheus metrics. On the left side, the dashboard shows Prometheus metrics aggregated by pod and EKS cluster. On the right side, the same metrics are aggregated across EKS clusters and across Amazon-managed service for Prometheus workspaces. All of this is done using a single data source, pointing to Promsky, which proxies the queries to every Amazon-managed service for Prometheus workspace that has been defined. You've just seen how to run queries across Amazon-managed service for Prometheus workspaces. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.